So you went to the doctor and the doctor said, no more jumping. Or maybe they just gave you a prescription. But if you're an American, there's a greater than a 1 in 5 chance that you've just been prescribed that drug off-label. What does off-label mean? Well, if the FDA has approved the drug you're using for your specific condition, then it's on-label. If it's approved the drug for condition A, but you're using it for condition B, then it's off-label. Why would you prescribe something off-label in the first place? Let's talk about drugs. Every drug that is legal to use in the United States has gone through an approval process via the FDA, the Food and Drug Administration. But it's thankfully not the case that drug companies can just rock up to the FDA and say, hi guys, we've got a great new drug we want to put on the market, you should approve it for everything. It currently takes about 12 years for a drug to go from conception to shelf, and that includes an average of 3.5 years of lab testing before the drug company can even apply to the FDA for approval to test in humans. There are then 3 phases of human trials. Phase 1, using healthy volunteers. Phase 2, using patient volunteers. And phase 3, a larger scale study using patients at clinics and hospitals. And only then can the company submit the drug to the FDA for final approval. If final approval is granted, the drug becomes legal for physicians to prescribe. But, and it's a big but, the drug has only technically been approved for the conditions for which it has been tested. Those phase 2 and phase 3 studies we mentioned, yeah, they form the basis of a drug's approved uses. Medication comes with a label and a packaging insert which tell you the drug's approved indications or on-label use. That is, what the FDA has said they think the drug is good for. So if a person has, say, sprained their ankle and it's swollen and it hurts and they take ibuprofen for it, that's an on-label use. Off-label use is when you use a drug in spite of the fact that it hasn't technically been studied for your condition or for your age group. Off-label use also covers when you make up a drug in a different formulation, like in liquid form for people who can't swallow pills. Now, there's nothing necessarily wrong with off-label use of drugs. Over-the-counter medications are used off-label all the time, but it does come with some extra risks because there haven't actually been any studies done to say that the drug works for your condition or doesn't actually make it worse in the long run. But if you, for example, have a condition which doesn't get a lot of research funding, and the drug that you're prescribed has been shown to alleviate some of the symptoms that you're experiencing, might as well give it a whirl? That's the theory, anyway. But while off-label prescribing is fine with the FDA, off-label marketing is not. Off-label marketing is when a company has a drug which is approved for use in condition A, but then they start telling people that, hey, you can also use it for condition B, and it's really good for that too. Off-label marketing is illegal, but that doesn't stop drug companies. Even paying tens or hundreds of millions of dollars in fines doesn't stop them. Off-label marketing is such a money spinner that the risks are generally worth the rewards. The thing is, the drug approval process is necessarily long and involved and expensive. So drug companies figure, well, if the drug's already approved and out there, may as well get as much money out of it as we can. This is the first in a series on drugs. Thanks as always to my patrons for their support. And if anyone would like to suggest an episode topic, you can do so down in the comments. Oh, and if you like this video and want to see more, you should hit the subscribe button and also ring that bell. See you next time.